You've been handed plenty of forms throughout your life. At the doctor's office, at school, for activities and programs. If you want to sign up or join something, you're usually going to have to fill out a form. In today's age, these forms are usually on websites and built with HTML. An HTML form is used to collect user input. The user input is then sent to a server for processing. The HTML form element is used to create a form. The form element is a container for different types of elements. One of the most used elements inside a form is the input element. The input element can be displayed in several different ways, depending on its type attribute. We have text fields, checkboxes, radio buttons, submit buttons, etc. Let's look at a real-life example. Input type text defines a single-line input field for text.
My name is Bill.
Input type radio displays a radio button. It lets a user select one option from a number of choices.
This one. The burger.
Input type checkbox displays a checkbox. It lets a user select many options from a number of choices.
Check, 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 check. I'll have all of those on my juicy burger.
There are many more input types you can use. Here's a quick list. In addition to the input element, there are several other elements we can use in forms. The select element defines a drop-down list. It's a partially hidden list that drops down with a list of options that you can choose from.
I'll pick this up at 5 o'clock.
The text area element defines a multi-line input field, where the user can input text with more than just a few words, like a comment field.
I would like my burger super well done.
Finally, let's add a submit button so Bill can send in his order. Input type submit defines a submit button.
I'm so hungry!
When submitting a form, the user input is sent to a file on a server for processing. To become a form expert, take a deeper dive into forms at w3schools.com.